my talk, I find, you know, I was able to trace down the evolution of scientometrics through that, you know, the business of science of science. Derek, in his book, used that term, the science of science, prologue to a science of science, mm-hmm. which is the term that Bernal had used. And then by the time another 10 years or so had gone by, scientometrics got into it because of Nalimov. Not clear to me when that precisely occurred, but the journal came in and Tibor Braun was more susceptible to Russian influence mm-hmm. because of the Hungarian location. Right. So they knew about scientometrics, but when did you first hear that term?
I guess it was.
You remember? Was it
1970?
I don't remember when I first saw his. You know, the CIA translated his book. It was free. I mean, it was available, but it wasn't talked about much. It was a government document. You could get it.
I wonder if science of science was somehow a Marxist idea or a Soviet idea.
Well, I'm pretty sure that was the way it was considered. It was, they discussed it at... Well, his whole like concept of, they give him credit for, and I said about Alvin Weinberg, who became, you know, his greatest exponent. Big science is what he called it, you know, and Derek was talking about little science. But it was Weinberg that made that distinction when being the head of a place like Oak Ridge Lab, you know, that's big science. And he talks about science the way Bernal did. So I said he was implicitly a Bernalian, Weinberg. And you write criteria for scientific choice.
Right.
That's
right.
The basis of... Did you know he wrote two commentaries for us in Citation Classics?
I remember.
Yeah? Oh, okay.
I never connected the criteria for scientific choice with Bernal, but now that you mention it...
Yeah, that was it. But he doesn't say it. I don't think he ever, to my knowledge, cited him. I don't think he did, but I'm sure he must have been known about it, but I'm not sure. So, fascinating how all these things interact. Josh Lederberg, he's thoroughly familiar with his work. Did you know that he wrote this paper in the East German Academy? He was invited to write a commentary about Bernal on the 50th anniversary of the social function of science. And when I went back and looked it up, turns out Josh wrote a paper in that called The Social Function of the Scientist, based on, you know, using that 50th anniversary. And then that paper was republished in an American book. I mean, American-based, I don't know who the publisher was, it might have been a Kluwer or somebody. And I couldn't figure out I saw the paper listed in his bibliography, and then I realized we had a, Meher found the book in my library, a shelf, it's sitting on my desk now, this is a collection of papers, and it's called Science and Society, or something like that, you know? If you've never seen it, Josh's paper is in there. And it has to do with the whole concept of what he calls truth-telling, you know, the ethics of science, so forth. So, Josh has some interesting comments there. Well, he said, basically, if the guy, his Marxist, the Marxist influence in his work, and he was blindsided by Stalin, and he wouldn't actually criticize Lysenko. That was the biggest mistake he ever made. I think most people feel that was clearly an emotional bias. Lou, he had shaky feelings about it.
Were you at all influenced by Vannevar Bush?
Well, I remember reading that as we may think.
Did that have any, all those...
When I was at the Twelves Project, I remember seeing an article by him in the Atlantic Monthly. There was a... but that occurred much earlier. I think his original, I'm trying to remember, there was something he wrote in the
40s,
early 50s that I had read, but before that, I had not known, I didn't know about Vannevar Bush before that. I heard about him through the rapid selector work and all that, you know, later. Essentially, up to 1951, till I went to that project, the only thing I ever knew about, I didn't relate Bernal to this at all. I mean, to documentation. I mean, when I was reading, it was science and the state, so to speak. You know, and that's what Weinberg was talking about, the government's giving great support to the science. Before that, science was private, you know, the upper crust, elite, and industrial. It wasn't government. After the war is what really produced the connection between government and science.